Hi everyone, this is Teacher Jane of Teach Talk, where learning is fun and easy. If this is your first time watching our videos, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button so you'll get notified on our next videos. Welcome to Shenshi Amazing! Shenshi Amazing! Kung saan pag-uusapan natin ang science concepts from grade 7 to grade 12, including topics in general science, biology, chemistry, physics, and earth science. At dito, bidang agham! Organisms need food to survive. They can make their own food, like autotrophs, or eat another organism, like heterotrophs. Because of this, food chains and food webs are formed. At yan ang topic natin ngayon. Ang sun ay ang source ng energy, which is the initial energy source. Ginagamit ito ng mga producers, gaya ng plants, to create their own food through a process called photosynthesis. Through being eat or eaten, a food chain is formed. It shows a single pathway from the producers to the consumers and show how energy flows in this pathway. For example, meron tayong food chain. It starts with the producer which uses the energy from the sun to create its own food. Ang plant ay kinakain ng isang organism which is called a consumer. There are a lot of consumers. Ang kumakain sa producer ay tinatawag na primary consumer or herbivore, which in this case is a grasshopper. Ang kumakain naman sa grasshopper ay tinatawag na secondary consumer. At ang kumakain naman sa second consumer ay tinatawag na tertiary consumer. And the food chain goes on. Organisms are eaten by other organisms. In food chain, meron tayong tinatawag na 10% rule. It means that when energy is passed in an ecosystem from one trophic level to the next, halimbawa mula sa producer papuntang consumer to another consumer, only 10% of the energy will be passed on. Let me show you how the 10% rule works. For example, meron tayong 1 million joules of sunlight. This is harnessed by the plants. 10,000 joules. Ito ang energy na makukuha ng primary producers. Kapag kinain ng isang consumer ang producer, only 10% is passed. Again, we just multiply it with 0.10. The answer is 1,000 joules. Ito ang energy na makukuha ng primary consumers. Kapag kinain naman ito ng iba pang organism, we just multiply it by 10% or 0.10, which is 100 joules. So, mga secondary consumers will only receive 100 joules mula sa 1 million joules ng sunlight. And once the secondary consumer is eaten, the energy that is passed on is only 10 joules. In our ecosystem, hindi independent ang isang food chain to another. They actually overlap. The natural interconnection of food chains in an ecosystem is called a food web. Ipinapakita nito kung paano mag-overlap ang mga food chains and how they interact with each other. For example, in this picture, we have a food web. In this food web, we can find a single pathway or a food chain. For example, we start with the berries, which are the producers. These berries will be eaten by a butterfly, which is the primary consumer. Then this butterfly will be eaten by a frog, which is the secondary consumer. Then this frog will be eaten by a snake, a tertiary consumer. After that, this snake may be eaten by another organism, making it another consumer. This pathway is just one of the many food chains seen in this food web.
That ends our Shenshi Amazing episode for today. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video to your friends so that we can learn together. Bye!